Good days to all my travelers, photographers and friends around the world. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channel. Wish you all in good health. It's been a year since I launched these travel channels, and for the 52 weeks, with more than 52 videos have been uploaded. And I'm pleased that I have kept to my promise of at least one episode of my travels per week. I would like to take this golden opportunity to thank all my viewers, travelers and photographers who have been constantly giving me the support and encouragement, particularly to Mr. Bernard and Mr. Ma. Further to my last week episode, in today's episode, which is the 7th episode of my travel journey to Guizhou province of China, I'm sharing with you of my walk around scenes of this awesome and fascinating Zhaoxing Dong Village, from dawn to dusk. Thereafter, I will share with you the images of a cultural performance of chorus of Dong people in the second half of this episode, and please stay tuned till the end. Now, the area color in red in this map of China is the whereabouts of Guizhou province. Now, in this Guizhou map, the location of Qingdonglan, Miao and Dong autonomous prefectures is been highlighted in yellow colors. Zhaoxing Dong Village is located in Liping County. Now, if you are first time logged into my travel channels and you want to have a better understanding of Guizhou province and the unique minority cultures, customs and traditions, please view at least the last 6 episodes of my journey to Guizhou. Now, it's important to note that my Guizhou journey took place in the year 2011. Thus, all the images in these travelogues are of 10 years old. Viewers are reminded that the present condition of these villages and living standard of villagers could be different from my travelogue images. Now, Liping County, beside Zhaoxing Dong Village, there are many smaller Dong villages, as can be seen in this tourist map. Now, let's take a look at this Zhaoxing Village map. You should be able to spot the river that flows through the village and find number of wind and rain bridges, as well as a fine number of drum tower. So let's begin our exploration of this lively and yet cultural filled Dong village from dawn to dusk. Now, Dong ladies and women are usually dressed in skirt or trousers with beautifully embroidered hems. Women wrap their legs and heads with scarf and set their hair in coy shape or styles in this image and the next image. Now, this image was taken in the early hours of the day next to the main street. Old and young were found sitting at the rows of steps in front of the shop houses. And the surrounding mountain view at the eastern side of the village. At about 8 a.m. in the morning, the main street started getting very busy with many passing by vehicles. villagers, young and old, also getting out of their houses and gather around their house or shops. Mobile stalls selling fresh vegetables, fruits and meat also been set up at the alleys just next to the main street. Farmers or traders from afar will gather at this main village by whatever means and way. This lady seemed to have a flat tire in the early morning. And for shop owner, they will start clearing and cleaning the front sections of their shop in preparation for the day business. Whether you are self-employed, farmer or civil servants, all got to get ready for the works. There is a beautiful and peaceful scene along the street next to the river. Villagers going to their farmlands in the early morning. This couple is a tobacco leaf traders. You can find more traders going to the marketplace in the morning. River is always the lifeline of human settlements, whether in the past, the present or futures. Along the river is where some of the daily activity are being carried out by the village folk, and also the best place to capture the local lifestyle. Such as washing of clothes or any items that require to be cleaned. Can you tell what this guy is washing? Let's look at the bucket behind him. What do you see? Now, some villagers will then let feed off their domesticated animals and let them roam around looking for their food along the riverbank, as can be seen in this image. At about 9 a.m. in the morning, shops started to open for business. You could spot many women working on with their needleworks in front of their house or shops. Now for some, just now as I earlier mentioned, for some that are selling the harvested crops from the day before. And you can find many male villagers, which are many artisans. They display their handmade products for sales at the shop corridors. You can find many of them are of old age. And while some of them will just sit there lazing off their time, And late in the afternoon, villagers start coming back from their farm works, carry with them are either the harvest of the days or the wheat or grass they clear from their farm. The wheat are used to feed the domesticated animal, such as buffalo. And for the harvest, they may need to be cleaned. Now in this image, the lady is washing the fresh vegetable just harvested from the farm using the river waters in preparation for the next day's sale at the marketplace. And just before the dinner or after the dinner, more villagers were found sitting just right in front of their houses, having a quality time with family members. They either chit-chat or playing with their children or grandchildren. And the men were found mostly sit on the rows of benches along the street or in the wind and rain bridges, having a talk three talk four sessions with other male villagers. Or just sitting alone along the covered corridor in front of their shop or house. Some will prefer having a games of chess, just for example, with friends. For some, taking a leisure evening walks. Now as for kids, most of them, the time for them is free and easy. So the fun time is the whole day. I found these two kids from the same families were washing their shoe after school. Now, you realize the clothing that are worn by the villagers are mostly in black colors. Most of these clothings, the cloths, are homemade cloths. And I spotted this young lady are dyeing their homemade clothes in her courtyard. After the cloth was dyed, of course in black colors, I then undergo a drying process under the sun. Then they will also undergo the process of continuously ramming or hammering that wooden hammer over thousands of times. Now, in this image, I want you to pay attention to the floor. This is actually a gravel paved floor. Can you see the patterns that have been set on this gravel paved floor? You can find this beautiful patented gravel paved floor around the village, almost in every corner. So this lady now is using a wooden hammer, hammering the dry up cloth. The support is a stone slab or stone blocks. My wife was curious enough to want to have a try, and the lady, the villager, stood behind her, probably thinking, you guys probably thinking this is an easy task and you want to try. Well, fine. I want to see how long can you last. And probably she have a smile in her heart. Now, before that, if any viewer, right, if any viewer will know the purpose of the hammering or ramming process in this cloth making used by the Dong innate minority, I would be much pleased or appreciated if you could provide me some feedback on the comment column below. During our day of visit, we encountered two major events took place. Firstly, there was a wedding procession. Now, the procession members first gathered at one of the wind and rain bridges before heading to the bride's home. And carrying with them our wedding present or betrothed's gift. And in this image, you notice the lady was laughing, looking up at the sky. She probably was so excited after realized there are so many cameramen were taking picture of her. And she probably thinking, well, I'm going to get famous soon. Before the procession start, they start form a line. And the man, the young man there are preparing the firecrackers. When the procession start, the firecracker will set off and will blast and hope to last until they reach the bride home. And on the same day, we also encounter with a funerary event. Just this funerary event, just like the Han custom. At the entrance of the deceased house was played with white paper couplets around the external face of the door. Right? Now, the funeral event usually took place the whole day. The morning is where they bring the coffins, the deceased, to the final place of rest. While in the afternoon, after the funeral processions, a funeral reception was then held at the deceased homes for the mourner or visiting guests. Now in this image, you can see the deceased family member, and their helpers were preparing the meals for the guests. The attire of the mourners or visiting guests are usually in black, and they will worn a white cloth on their heads, and this white cloth will then reach all the way down to the ground level, as can be seen in this image. Now, as this Dong village have no entertainment outlets and no street light, when night falls, the whole village will be in pitch dark. After dinner, most villagers prefer to stay at home and go to bed early. Furthermore, their occupation are mainly farmers. They need to get up early the next days. So this image and the next few images are the evening scenes around the village. And finally, the nightfall, the street scene at night, with only few shops still open for business. I'm glad that we have come to now the second part of these travelogues. That is the Dong cultural performance, the grand song of Dong people. This show was rated first in the 13th CCTV youth singing competitions. Now, the Dong ethnic minority is stand out amongst many ethnic minorities found in China for its songs and singing skill. They always believe that song are a way to remember and appreciate their origin, as they do not have a written language not until 1958. And before 1958, their stories had been preserved through the use of song and passed down from generations to generations. Now, the Dong Grand Song or Da Ge in Chinese are some of the most dynamic songs in Chinese folk music and a distinctive form of artistic expressions in China, performed mainly without any help of musical instruments. Besides this, the Grand Song is performed by a large group of people without a conductor. Now, the song can be solo or chorus with multiple voice parts, with graceful melodies, free rhythms, or sometimes calm and fluent, and sometimes smart and bold. Now, Grand Song not only folk music, but also the cultural symbols of the Dong ethnic minority groups. They are the stories of the Dong cultures, and for this reason, the Grand Song, also been called an encyclopedia of Dong social custom. And today, Grand Song remain a crucial symbol of Dong ethnic identity and cultural heritage, and forming an intangible cultural heritage of humanity. This is a special arranged cultural show, the Chorus of Dong People, for visiting guests of the Zhaoxing Village. Visitors should not miss the opportunity of witnessing this awesome cultural show. The grand songs are usually performed formally in drum towers, the landmark venues for ritual, entertainments, and meeting. It was an hour plus long cultural show or folk performance with song and dance by the villagers. The show normally end with the all-in dance events, whereby the guests will be invited to join in the circle dance with the performer. And what a great ending for the show. One of the lady performer was a young mother. We managed to have a group photo with her child. Lastly, in these travelogues, I would like to share some of this photograph taken in a form of street abstract, which I like most. Photographer, if you are observant enough, you should be able to capture some very interesting images in any trips. This photo shows the tobacco leaf, the dry tobacco leaf. Finally, here come the end of the 7th episode of my journeys to Guizhou, and hoped you have been entertained, alright? If you like my travel channels, please support by subscribing, share and like. A thumb up from you is very important to me. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you in advance for supporting this travel channel. And just a preview of the 8 episodes, I will bring you to 2 more traditional Dong villages located in a very scenic valleys not far from Zhaoxing Village, and a historical street dominated by Dong minority in the Liping County, and please stay tuned. And before I end, I would like to wish you all good health. Please stay safe. Stay strong. See you next week. And bye.